Hello, sweet people. Una, welcome back again. So as we progress for this course, one of those things that we will need for advance na absolute value. And so, because of the relationships that we did in between equality and these inequalities, then will be say small plus sign or big plus or equal to sign. Big plus sign or small plus or equal to sign. So because of the relationships then with the in between this equality and inequality is then, so it will make sense to depict our absolute values then with equation and inequality, so that we will see the clear picture of the way the absolute value take affect equation and inequalities then. So we'll start with equation. We'll consider this number line. We get 3 units from 0. So this number line get 3 units from 0. So with an absolute value, the axis in terms of number, we say, which will be the exact amount of units or number where something gets from 0. So if we consider 0 as our reference point, so from 0 to this direction, the exact amount of unit now 3, irrespective of in direction or in sign. So now from 0 to this direction, the exact amount of unit now 3. So now waiting absolute value to tell us be that. So absolute value just be like concept, just be like idea. We be say to like understand them, we must envision like the meaning. Okay, so like the meaning, we say, you know, get anything to do with the direction of like our value. You no one know whether na negative or positive. You just want to know the exact amount we be say the thing be. So we'll say since the exact amount of this unit from this direction from 0 now 3 and from this direction now 3, so if we say the absolute value of maybe one particular number x, we'll say x now 3. So if we say the absolute value of x now 3, what do we mean? We say from 0 to any direction, to either this direction or this direction, na 3. And to this direction, we know say we will get negative 3. And to this direction, we will get positive 3. And so that's why absolute value, they mostly get 2 results. Most times, they always get 2 results. Because why? If they turn negative values them to positive answer. And the answer of our absolute value, they always be positive. Absolute value nothing be negative. So now, the mathematics definition of absolute value. Now say, absolute value, now the distance where we get from 0. That is the distance of that particular number from 0. So from year to year, if you count 1, 2, 3. So the distance, now waiting, now 3. So irrespective of the direction, the distance now 3. That the most important thing be that. So most say we don't understand that one. So if we say the absolute value of one particular number will be x na 3, what do we mean by saying which number will we put inside this place? What if we represent x, we will be 3. If we put 3, will be positive for here, it will be 3. If we put minus 3 for here, it will be 3. So therefore, if we say the absolute value of x na either x na minus 3 or x na 3. So this one are just the explanation. But for mathematics, we get this concept like piecewise definition and square root definition. We just tell us, say, if we take the absolute value of one particular input, then just like minus 3 as input or 3 as input, the absolute value will give us positive result. So before we talk about this piecewise definition or square root, we'll just go through all these small things there. So now we'll talk about zero. If the absolute of one particular number now zero, so within this one maybe say like we don't need to consider any direction. Like if we get our number line, we get zero for here. So we don't need to consider like any of this direction. Now only one solution now we get for this case. So the absolute value of zero now, zero. Now one solution we get. So now if we get x equal minus 3. So anytime we like we see the result of our absolute value as the negativity of one particular number, like we just understand say it just the impossible. Because within this one, the ask us be say which value of x, which value if we put for this x out of this real number line, okay, where will give us negative 3. So if we check and well, we just say it's just the impossible. We will not get any number where if we put for this x, we will give us negative 3. If you put 0 for here, 0 no fide equal to negative 3. If you put any negative answer, if you represent this x with any negative number, say minus 5, minus 4, minus 100, minus anything, okay, or negative anything. So the answer will turn to positive because of this sign. So this sign will neutralize the negativity within inside that input. It will turn out to positive. So what we will always get, anytime we get absolute value, we say we must always get one particular number. It will be either zero or make a big pass zero. Okay? We say we don't become this piecewise definition, small. So if they talk about non-negative number, the result of absolute value, it will always be non-negative numbers then. Either make it be zero or make it be positive numbers then. So, and the case be that we don't say the first case with absolute value or most of the time with absolute value, we get two solutions as our answer. But sometimes we get one solution for this case. And the only time we say we get no solution for our absolute value, now when the result of the absolute value is negative 3, because it's just the impossible. If you put any number inside this place to represent x, that number must big pass negative number will be 3. Whether 3, whether minus 1, as long as within there is negative, it's just the impossible. So we'll just say no solution and we'll represent them with this null. So now, don't talk about equation. And before we talk about inequality, one thing we must remember be say with equation, they talk about equality. Say within the one side must they equal to within the other side. But with inequality, they tell us say, for instance, if we get 5 for here, they tell us say we get plenty numbers then, like infinite amount of number then, like 6, 7, 8, and so on. We will say big pass this 5. So we won't see the way absolute values, the way if we take relate absolute value with this definition of inequality. So then, if we say the inequality of one particular number, say x small pass 3. So what it mean? We say, we represent them for number line. 0 for here. So what in this concept mean? We say, now what be those numbers then? Where small pass this 3. Wetin be the exact amount of those number them? That is the exact amount of those number them we small pass 3. And to know those number them we small pass 3, from this 0, okay, from this 0 to this place, we just say 1, irrespective of the direction. This, see the direction here, okay? So, irrespective of this direction, we go see, say, now 3 units be this. So, numbers, they will be say small pass 3. It will be either from this, this point 3, no follow. So, we go say, if it be like, since this this 3 no follow, so if we represent them like this, we mean, I will explain them later. So this other one go mean say this 3 no follow. So when we say something small past 3, it means say like 3 no fit small past itself. But we forget like 2, we forget 2, we forget 1. So we forget any number, we forget 2.999999. So if we get decimals, then we'll be say small pass minus 3. So now waiting, this one it tell us be that. So waiting be those numbers, then we'll be say small pass 3 unit from 0. So since now small pass sign we get for them, we say 3, no day. So if we just say now these numbers then from 0. Okay, so and the same thing for this side. Number that will small pass 3. 3 no fit small pass itself. So now any number that will be said day from this place come like this. So now the representation of this one be that this first one, we should say x small pass no this number minus 1 minus 2, then big pass 3. So x big pass minus 3, but x small pass 3. Because 2 small pass 3, 1 small pass 3. So 0 small pass 3. So now the representation of the first one be that. So the second one, within the second one, mean be say, more right and back. So waiting the second one, mean be say, the second one say, waiting be those exact amount of number then we big pass 3. Okay, so number then we big pass 3. Since we talk about the exact, we not get anything to do with the direction or the sign. We talk about the exact. So if it be numbers in like 4, 5, 6, or make it be negative 4, negative 5. Since now the exact, we mean. So, since we talk about the exact, then, from 3, we will get this representation because we mean say x big pass 3. So if x big pass 3, any number way they in between this 3 and 4 go this direction, we feel satisfy this our inequality. And any number will be say the in between this minus 3 and 4, we feel satisfy this inequality. So we get x big pass 3 will be this one and x small pass 3. So x small pass negative 3. So then the input will satisfy this inequality, we say x big pass 3, then the input what if we put inside this place, we will satisfy this inequality. Now, those numbers, maybe say small pass negative 3, and those numbers then we say big pass 3. If we put them inside this place, this, with the help of this absolute symbol, it will turn out to positive. So then it will make a big pass this 3. So now the two cases then we remain. Before we talk about the two cases then we remain, more don't forget say we fit get bar for here. Bar. Okay, we fit get bar for here, small pass or equal to sign. We fit get big pass or equal to sign. So we fit get, but the like the basic concept now to understand them with at least one of these signs, because they're similar to themselves. The only difference now when we want to represent them for either interval, for interval or for our set notation. So now we don't talk about this one and this one. So this one again, okay, when the absolute value of one particular number small pass negative 3. So one of the only time we say we get non-solution with inequality. Now when, because it's just the impossible, tell me which number if you put inside this absolute value, we go give us, we go small pass negative 3. We know say normally absolute value no fit be negative. So no amount of value, most say we put negative 20. Okay, but when we put our absolute, it will turn to 20. 20 no fit small pass negative 3. So no matter the number ABC we put for this place, we go always get number ABC big pass negative numbers then. If we get 0, or more could get positive number then. So anytime we see something like that, we'll just say nah, no solution. And so the last one, within the last one, they tell us, they say, if we get the absolute value of one particular number, say x, big pass, negative 3. So now, which numbers then, if we put inside this input, this x, where will give us the answer, we go big pass, negative 3. If we put 0 for here, will you say, if we put 0 for here and take the absolute, it go big pass, 0 big pass, negative 3. If it be negative 3, if it be negative of any number. So we will see, say, after all, no matter the number we put for inside this x, any number we say we put for inside this x, whether negative number or positive number or 0, all of them must big pass this negative number. If it be negative 1, if it be negative of anything, as long as not negative, then this side. So for this kind of situation, would they say the solution of our inequality now all now the whole real number? So see our number line, irrespective of complex numbers there. So like now just like our real number line. So any number I say we pick for our real number line, it will satisfy this inequality. So that's why we say the solution are all real number. So now the basic concept of waiting absolute value be that in terms of equation and inequality. So now we'll just talk about this piecewise definition, and then we'll graph one example of our absolute equation and absolute inequality. So now the piecewise definition of x, they just like show us the easiest way we take pieces or we take organize this idea of absolute value of the absolutivity. So now to start again, if we get the absolute value of one particular number, so the simplest understanding of this thing be say, if we get plus 3 for here, okay, we'll just say this one a plus, put the plus there, plus 3. Plus times plus, now waiting, now plus, so now 3. If you get minus 3, just put the minus for there first, minus, then put the whole minus 3, minus 3. So minus times minus, go waiting, 3. So like the general overview or idea or concept of this absolute value, now say the result must be positive number. So yes, and to represent them for piecewise function, they tell us there, if you put positive input or non-negative number for this absolute value, and non-negative value, they want to represent non-negative value. So if x na non-negative, that is non-negative means everything with the big pass or equal zero. So whole numbers in a non-negative number because it starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. So na non-negative number. So for mathematics, now so they represent non-negative number. X big pass or equal zero. So now non-negative number. So for any non-negative number when we put for inside this place, if our non-negative number na x, okay, our result will be x. So for any negative number, in case we choose any negative number, we'll say minus 3. So this piecewise function, you tell us, say, we'll just put one minus for the front first, then later we put our input, maybe minus 3, so that we go fit turn on to 3, to positive, so that at least our end point go fit be that exact positive number we say we define. So, and to make the matter simple, we get the square root definition of absolute value. We see the tell us say if we get the absolute value of one particular number, say 3. Say what it mean be say now the square root of the square of that number. You see, the reason why they put the square now just to come out that negative sign. Okay, to come out any sign we go there. So now just to come out this one, we cancel this one now the inverse. So then we will get our 3 for here. We get 3 for here, okay? So because it don't cancel. And if we get, maybe say, minus 3. So we go see and say, minus 3 square. This one, if we square this one, it will cancel itself. So we will get 3 for here. So the general idea of this concept then, like they tell us again, say absolute value, just they tell us the amount of distance or units we say we get from zero. So now, we'll graph one example. Maybe it will help us understand that well. Yeah, so now we'll consider one example where we will take graph the function. So, we'll say we get f of x equal the absolute value of x plus 2 minus 1. So before we graph this function, we'll see the picture of our absolute function. If we get this graph, the graph of our absolute value, the basic graph, now this V shape, okay? If we get f of x equal the absolute value of x. So now the picture of our basic absolute function be this. So anytime we want to draw the graph of absolute value, so we expect at least this basic V shape, okay? So now, since we get this equality sign, it tell us say the solution of this equality, now anything within this place must be equal to within this place. So now, the solution of this function, now those points, they will be say, they this line, okay? So those point them, those exact point, like maybe this point, where x and y take meet. So now only those points then will be the solution of our equality. Whereas for inequality, say we get inequality will be f of x small pass or equal this the absolute value of x. So this one just tell us say our solution, now infinite solution, will be say we did this region. That is, we will shade everything we say the under our graph. So now the basic idea of the picture of our absolute function be that. So now, since we don't know that one, we'll solve and graph this function. So graph the function. So now, to graph the function of absolute, to graph any function, we get absolute value. Since we must first ask ourselves, since we get absolute value for the, which shape would expect? Would expect this V shape, okay? Just like our parabola. Would you draw our parabola from center? Go like this, because we understand, say we get one turning point, where we say the distance between this place and this place, take the equal. So the same thing with our vertex, we get one, the same thing with our absolute graph. Now V shape, okay, and that V shape, would get one vertex, will be like the center point for here, okay? So that vertex just be like the turning point. For us to draw parabola, we must know the vertex, because with the vertex, we will know the center of our parabola and where it's supposed to be for our Cartesian plane. So now, since we already know, say we will need vertex for, now to draw this graph, this function, we know, so we will need vertex, because with the sign of absolute value for there, we know, say the shape of our function go be V shape, and V shape get corner. So within the vertex, we say vertex now where two things take meet, that is something we get corner. You see, it get corner. This place where these two lines and take meet, this point now vertex, this point now vertex. So this point now vertex, where this line take go like this and this one take go like this, where two things take meet now vertex. So because we already picture, because sometimes we must just know the picture of what we want to do, okay? Algebraically, if we find the vertex of this one, and then when we know the vertex, we will need vertex, then the ingredient, then or instrument, then we say we need to do this function. One, we will need vertex, we will check whether it gets intercept, because it must cross y axis, okay? But not the necessary to make it cross x axis. If we get absolute value, we be like this, we no cross x value, and we forget we no cross x axis, and we forget one we be saying cross x, we cross x axis, like we go cross x axis like this, cross x axis for any point. So we'll check whether this function go give us some certain things, them like ingredients, them stuff, them maybe like the vertex, the intercept, so that because with those things, then we will easily draw the graph. You know, go easy to draw. So now we'll find the vertex of this function. So one simple formula we would use, we say normally we get the vertex formula will be a into x minus h plus k. When we say if this our a, now they positive, then our function go face up. So because for this place our a now one now positive, we already know say when we go graph our function, this function go face upside, they go open up. So we'll keep that one for our mind. Now one instrument be that we say we go need. So the second thing we say, we need this vertex h and k. Now the x and y coordinate of our vertex. So with our vertex, we will find this particular point. So now we'll find the vertex of this function. So to do so, we will easily say minus h equal 2, h equal 2, and k equal minus 1. We will easily compare within the year to within the year, then we'll get our vertex. But within our mode, they use, in case of complex problem, we say to get our the x coordinate, to get the x coordinate of our vertex, we'll just insert everything with the equation to 0. Say put into 0, we'll get x plus 2 equal 0. Our x equal minus 2. So our vertex, see our vertex, one second instrument, now our vertex, we get negative 2 as the x coordinate of our vertex, then the y coordinate of our vertex, now the f of minus 2. So if we insert x of f of minus 2 for this function, we get minus 2 plus 2 minus 1. So this one will be 0 minus 1. Absolute value of 0, now written, 0 minus 1 will be written minus 1. So now we know say this function don't give us one, this function don't tell us say the function will open up. The function don't give us our vertex point, will be this one. So now, because we need y-intercept, because every like this function, it must cross y-axis, but not the necessary for them, just like parabola, not the necessary to cross x-axis. So now be that for our vertex. So now we'll find the intercept, the y-intercept. So now to get the y-intercept, we use our intercept form. We may say to get y-intercept, we go insert 0, we go make x 0. So if x na 0 for here, if we make x 0, we get 0 plus 2 minus 1. We will be 2 minus 1. We will be waiting. We will be 2 minus 1. We will be 1. Okay? So if x na 0, we will get 1. So our y intercept na, if x na 0, we will get with 1. So our y intercept na 0, 1. So the next instrument we will need, we say we will need our x intercept. So once we don't get our vertex and with our intercepts there, then we don't be ready to go. So now x intercept. To get our x intercept, we must make our y 0. So we'll say we get y equal x plus 2 minus 1. Because this y and f of x with the interchanger. So now if we make our y 0, we'll get 0 equal x plus 2 minus 1. So if we bring 1 come this side, we'll get 1 equal x plus 2. Okay, so if we write this one as x plus 2 equal 1. So and now from the definition of our absolute value, we know say everything we did will give us the positive value, or will give us this value, or the opposite of this value. So the solution to remove this absolute value, we get x plus 2 equal 1, or x plus 2 equal minus 1. So if we solve algebraically, we will get for here, we will get x equal 1 minus 2, x equal 1 minus 2, now waiting, now minus 1. So for here, if we solve them, we will get more comma 2 for the two sides, minus 2 for here, minus 2 for here, we will get x equal minus 1 minus 2 minus 3. So now for our x intercept, we get two answers. 1 minus 3 comma 0, that is x intercept, and then we get minus 1 comma 0 minus 1 comma 0. So now we don't get all the ingredients then we will need to take draw our the graph of our absolute function. So we'll just sketch the graph. We'll sketch the graph well. X, y-axis. So now, first, we'll locate our vertex. Our vertex now, negative 2, our x and negative 2. Negative 2, and our y and negative 1. Negative 1. So, negative 2 down negative 1. So, for this point, we'll get our vertex will be negative 2, comma, negative 1. So, we get our vertex for this point. So, now the next point, now our intercept. So, when x now 0, we get 1 for here. So, we get our 0 comma 1 for here when x na 0, y na 1. So now we get our intercept. The graph must pass through this place. So now our x intercept minus 3, x na minus 3, we get minus 3 for here. We'll locate that point. And then x na minus 1. Minus 1 comma 0. Y na 0 for this place. So we get minus 1. We get this point. So now, since our sign now equal to sign, then we'll trace the line with both line. So we will get So we'll get this curve. So 9 be that for this function. See our vertex, see our x intercept, see our y intercept. So now we don't say the domain, they don't ask us this one, but because of later explanation, we don't say the domain of this function now negative infinity, comma positive infinity. That is the domain, the x value. Would always use domain with x value, and then the range now for y would always use range for y to show like maybe the vertical distance. So the range for here, we just say now from this minus 1, okay, from minus 1 to positive infinity, to positive infinity. So this one are the range, this one are the domain. So now the domain. So basically, now the idea of absolute value be this. So for the next lesson, we will take some examples. Then we'll be say good day, complex, pass this one, and then from there we'll go continue to the limits of functions then.